friends, we'll solve problem on kinematics of rigid bodies. Let's see what is given in problem. For a crank and slider mechanism shown in figure, determine the instantaneous center of rotation of connecting rod at position shown. The crank OQ rotates clockwise at 310 rpm. Crank length is 10 cm. Connecting rod length is 50 cm. Also find the velocity of P and angular velocity of rod at that instant. Figure is given in problem. Just see figure. What is given? OQ is a crank inclined at 60 degree with horizontal. Then link PQ means connecting rod. Its length is 50 cm. Connecting rod PQ rotates about instantaneous center of rotation because it doesn't rotate about any hinge support. But crank OQ rotates about hinge support O. Therefore, crank OQ performs pure rotational motion. Now, this crank rotates in which direction is given in problem? Crank OQ rotates clockwise at 310 rpm. Direction of rotation is important here. As crank OQ rotates in clockwise direction, I will write here omega OQ. As crank rotates in clockwise direction, linear velocity of point Q, if you want to decide, it is perpendicular to radius of rotation. Therefore, perpendicular to OQ, and in the same sense of omega equal represent, you will get linear velocity of point Q, VQ like this. As Q moves in upward direction, which one is end of link PQ or connecting rod PQ, at other end, slider P is connected. As Q moves in rightward direction, slider P has to slide in horizontal direction because its motion is restricted, and that is also in rightward direction. Therefore, it will represent linear velocity of point P as VP. Now, on link PQ, you know direction of two points P and Q. If you want to represent now ICR, will represent perpendicular to VQ and perpendicular to VP. Perpendicular to VP, you will get vertical line because VP horizontal. Perpendicular to VP, straight vertical line. And perpendicular to VQ, if will represent, you will get what? Extension of same line OQ, where we will get point of intersection on this vertical line. Therefore, center of rotation or ICR for link PQ is point I. Now, to find out length IP and IQ, you must know inclinations in this triangle IPQ. This angle is 60 with horizontal, same line represented here. That means this angle must be here 30 degree with vertical. Now, anyhow, if we'll find out this angle, which one is possible from this inclination of PQ with horizontal? Say this angle is alpha. Angle alpha will find out from triangle OPQ applying sine rule, because one length is known, opposite angle is known. This length is known, opposite angle easily will get using sine rule. Once we will get angle alpha, 90 minus alpha, we will get inclination of IP with PQ. 180 minus these two angles, if we will subtract these two angles, what we will get? Third, you can see this angle in this triangle. Therefore, IP and IQ are possible. That means next step is what? In triangle IPQ, we will apply sine rule and we will find out angle alpha. Therefore, see on next page. In triangle OPQ, applying sine rule, we are interested in angle alpha. Therefore, OQ upon sine of alpha, where OQ length is 10 cm As OQ length is a 10 centimeter, in meters if we substitute, this is 0.1 meter equal to next length, what is known is a PQ, where length PQ is given as 50 centimeter, I'll write in meters, 0.5 divided by sine of opposite angle is what, 60 degree. From this one, angle alpha comes out to be 9.97 degrees. Once we'll get this angle, we'll find out other two angles from again our main figure. Therefore, see figure of this problem. This angle what you calculated is 9.97 degrees. Therefore, this angle is 90 minus 9.97. That means approximately 10. That means this angle comes out to be 80.03 degrees. And this is 80 and 30 means 110. That means this angle must be 70 or 69.97 degrees. Now in triangle IPQ, you know all angles. Therefore, IP and IQ is possible applying sine rule. We'll apply sine rule and find out IP and IQ. Therefore, again see next page. In triangle IPQ, we'll apply sine rule. Applying sine rule, what will get here? IP upon sine. Opposite angle is 69.97 degrees, equal to IQ, which is again unknown, opposite angle 80.03, equal to known length is a PQ, where length PQ is 50 centimeter means 0.5 meter divided by sine of opposite angle is 30 degree. Now using calculator, we'll find out this lengths. What will get here? IP. IP comes out to be 0.94 meters and length IQ equal to 0.98 meters. Now all lengths are ready. Therefore, if we'll apply our equation V equal to R omega for these both the lengths, easily we'll get solution of problem. Therefore, first equation will apply for length OQ. See next page. For length OQ, now for length OQ, angular velocity in radians per second is not given. What is given? RPM of link is given, which one is represented by N, and that is 310. Now if you want to convert this RPM into radians per second, you know this one N means revolution per minute. One revolution means 2 pi radians. Therefore, if I multiply here 2 pi to this, say any number of revolution, but this is revolution per minute, so we'll convert this minute in second. So what will get? 2 pi n by 60 as a standard formula of omega, where n, if I'll substitute here, 2 pi into 310 divided by 60, what omega will get here is 32.46 radians per second. As omega is known, for this link, I'll first apply equation for this point Q equal to radius of rotation is distance of point Q from point O. Therefore, what will get here? OQ into omega of link OQ. Length OQ is 10 centimeter means 0.1 meter. And omega OQ you are getting as 32.46. Therefore, this velocity of point Q comes out to be 3.246 meters per second. Once we'll get this linear velocity of point Q, next for for link PQ if we'll write equation, point Q is common, therefore VQ is equal to IQ into omega PQ. Therefore VQ is known, 3.246 equal to IQ length you have calculated, which one is 0.98 into omega PQ. Therefore omega PQ comes out to be 3.295 radians per second and direction of omega anticlockwise. Similarly, for next point P, if we'll apply, its distance from center of rotation is IP into omega PQ. IP is 0.94 into 3.312. Therefore, VP comes out to be 3.097 meters per second and in direction is rightward. That means VP, you have to find out, this one is one answer, and angular velocity of link PQ anticlockwise, this one is next answer. Thank you.